Hello everyone. So welcome back to building the virtual assistant using Python with Brian. So in this video, we will learn how to, make a Google search only through our voice. So we will basically just say, search XYZ, and only XYZ, whatever we say, will be on the Google search, and the enter button will be pressed and it'll give us the results on Google itself. So all you have to do is say the word search and whatever we want to search further. All the work will be done by our virtual assistant, which we will build right now. And also an extra feature for programmers. So it's just a very simple feature. So what I've added to it is, you just need to tell, I need help in Python. It will give you a list of three options from the very famous three websites called Geeks for Geeks, W3 Schools and Stack Overflow. So you just say the word Geeks for Geeks, Stack Overflow or W3 Schools. It will actually open their website and you can search there whatever help you need in Python. It's pretty basic. We can stick with that. So without wasting time, let's get started with the program. So before starting the program, we'll have to implement or, get a module or library called web browser. It's using that we are going to use the search function as well as the I need help in Python function. So let's import the library called web browser. So we'll just write import web browser. It's come here as well. So this is the library, import web browser. And after importing the web browser, we need to, okay. Now, just as we had the variable text in which the input audio was being stored, so that we'll compare that using the Google search engine and convert it into a text and then compare that what is it that we have spoken and what is it that needs to be done. We'll use that here as well. So if search in string text dot lower, what do you need to do? Okay, so if it is here in input text dot lower, we need to do is we need to actually give another variable called search is equal to, we will have to replace the word search from the input string text search dot replace, where's replace? Okay, it's not there. Okay, so what have we done here is we have actually used the word if search and what the input audio is there, then replace the word search from the input variable text, input variable which has a string, yeah, replace the word search with a white space. Now why are we doing this is because we will just be saying search Tesla, search XYZ or search anything we would like to. Now we don't want the word search to be as well printed on the Google search engine and search that as well. So we will just, say search XYZ and only the word XYZ will be, used in the Google search engine and that is what is going to be searched. So that is why we are replacing the word search explicitly and we will just use the words after the word search we have said to do the search function. Now we will say web browser dot open new tab and in that we will pass the variable search because this contains except the word search everything else we have set and we will also give another function called time dot sleep, sleep as 8 seconds. Now why we're doing this is because the moment if you don't give time dot sleep, the moment the web browser opens it will close that very moment itself. Because the program is executing, we have just told the program to open the web browser, but the program closes the web browser as well. So it will open and close. We want to realize when the browser was opened. So for that, we need to pass a function called time.sleep for 8 seconds. That means once you have opened the browser with the specified search word, sleep for at least 8 seconds and leave it as is. So we can at least see the output, how it works. So let's check. Hello, Jarvis.
Hey, Brian, how can I help you?
Search Tesla. Perfect. How cool was that? So we just need to say search whatever we want to. That specific word will be searched here and the browser will be opened. Even when the browser is not opened, the browser will be opened explicitly for this one search. And this is open new tab. Okay. So it won't, if we are going to search another something, it'll not open in the same tab. It'll not open in the same, what do you say, tab. It'll open a completely new tab. Now if I say, hello Jarvis.
Speak my name.
Hello Jarvis.
Hey Brian, how can I help you?
Search Aishwarya Rai. See, it's opened a completely new tab. There is no, the previous Tesla one I had not closed. It's still here. It is not present here. It's opened a new browser itself. It's not opened a new tab. It's opened a new browser itself. That's more clear. Okay. So see, that's how this works. It's as simple as that. Now, like I mentioned before, we need to, I will say something like I need help in Python. It will give me a list of three very famous sites called Geeks for Geeks, W3 Schools, and Stack Overflow. So it's given me these three options, which one I would like to open. I will suggest, okay, open this one. It'll open that specific link. Not necessarily, I'll need help only in Python. You could be using something else. You can just say, I need help in XYZ. I need help in programming. Maybe I need help in anything, or I need you to open anything. You can just give it anything. It's just a, simple time pass function. So I'll just go like, I need help in Python in string text dot lower. Then what do you need to do? If this is there, first you need to do is, I have this already with me. No need to type and waste my time. Okay, so what you need to do is, first you will print on the output screen Geeks for Geeks, second number W3 Schools, third is Stack Overflow. Which one would you like me to open? It'll ask me that question. I will give it an variable called site is equal to get audio. Now, since it has asked me that which one you would like me to open, I would like it to listen. That right, you have asked me something, I will tell you something. So for that, I'll call the function get audio. Store the audio as a string which has already been converted using the Google engine in a variable called site. And I'll be using this variable to for further comparisons. Like if XYZ is present in this string, get me this link. So I already have this, I'll just paste that. Okay, so if one in string dot lower or geeks for geeks in string dot lower in the string site exactly, print opening geeks for geeks, even say opening geeks for geeks, and most importantly web browser dot open that specific link. Let's just try it out. Hello, Jarvis.
Hey Brian, how can I help you?
I need help in Python.
Which one would you like me to open?
Geeks for Geeks. Oh, come on. See, if you are a person who speaks quite fast, then you may not need this space in Geeks for Geeks. But if you are someone who speaks slowly, hello, Jarvis.
Hey Brian, how can I help you?
I need help in Python.
Which one would you like me to open?
Geeks for Geeks.
Opening Geeks for Geeks.
So there you go. Geeks for Geeks has been opened with Python. Chrome browser was not even opened. Chrome browser was not even opened. It opens the Chrome browser itself, a new tab in the Chrome browser. And in that, it'll search the specific link that we have specified. Okay, so we've tested this, it works. We can add the W3 schools as well as Stack Overflow to this. So it's so simple, it's not at all, any big thing. It's pretty easy. So we have your. W3 schools has been added. We can quickly add Stack Overflow. Now I thought I had the link for Stack Overflow, but I do not. So I'll have to go and get it. Just give me a minute. Web browser dot open. Just get the link. Stack Overflow. This is the link here. StackOverflow.com. Copy and we come to a program. Just paste it right here. We're just testing this right now. Hello, Jarvis.
Hey, Brian. How can I help you?
I need help in Python.
Which one would you like me to open?
Stack Overflow.
Opening Stack Overflow.
Stack Overflow has been opened. This is the link that we took, and this is the link it opened. It's exactly the same link as you all can see. So that's great. So this program is pretty simple. We tested it. It's working good. You can add it to your program. You can give any link you would want it to open. Maybe just say open WhatsApp, open YouTube, open Google, anything. We are going to come to open YouTube also. So it's exactly same thing. We just don't need to anything in that. Just say open YouTube. It'll open YouTube. Web browser dot open. I have the whole code here. I'll just paste it. Open YouTube. It'll do that. Open WhatsApp. It'll do that. Copy and paste. Open WhatsApp. Okay. Oh, my bad. I pasted open YouTube and WhatsApp within the I need help in Python. Okay, now it's out of Python. So, hello, Jarvis.
Hey, Brian, how can I help you?
Open YouTube.
Opening YouTube.
So there you go. We have YouTube opened. All we need to say is open XYZ, give the link. It'll open that within seconds. So the program is pretty simple, pretty efficient, and very, very useful. So there you go. This is done. Thank you very much. I'll see you very soon in the next videos with upcoming many more brilliant features. Thank you.